Okay, so I'm gonna take you through exactly how to craft and design a custom prompt live on this video. So I actually have not done this yet, which means it might be a little scrappy. I'm gonna take you through the process that I use to actually formulate the custom response. So this is not about technically how you save custom prompts, although I guess it does show you that. It's more about the thinking around it and how I think about custom prompts, which is something that I think I'm pretty good at. So anyway, this here is a voice transcription that I have. It's from a paragliding flight that I just did. So I want to create a AI prompt for a flight log because I've gotten really bad at recording my flights after I do them. And I basically want to just record a voice note, run an AI prompt on it, and then have that all saved and stuff. So let's get going. I'm gonna highlight this text and then I'll click on the magic stars. You could also use Command J to pull up this AI assistant. And here we have a list of our prompts. So all of these up top are custom that I've saved. All of these at the bottom are system. And basically we are gonna take an existing prompt and copy it, edit it, and save it. And the most helpful to choose what's the closest to your prompt so that you don't have to edit it too much. In general, I think the super summarizer, which is close to the bottom here, is a really good one to start with. So I'm gonna click on that. And gonna start running here, but I will so I should use escape, stop it. And I'm gonna open it up here and see what's happening. The reason I think the super summarizer is a good one to start with in clone is because it has all of these components. So it's like summarize, keep the essential information, don't provide any external information. And then it's got some really helpful things like it will automatically add backlinks for you and stuff like that. So what I'm going to do, I'm gonna clone this. And then I'm going to call it paraglide flight log and save that. Well, actually, before I save that, I'm going to go through and do some editing here. So I could save it, but then I would have to pull it up again. So anyway, instead of a professional summarizer, I'll say you're a professional paraglider. Create a concise and comprehensive, I'll say formatted summary of the, I'm gonna say flight context, because that's what it is, and adhere to these guidelines. Okay, so that's the introduction. Now we're gonna move on to the next section, which is guidelines. So some of these I'll keep, some of these I will delete. I'm gonna keep that. And again, I'm gonna put that's formatted, gonna be a really big part of this. I might not need to put it in there. But I'm gonna keep it in there just to be safe. Incorporate main ideas. Nope, I don't want that because I mean no, I don't want that because it's just a flight log. So I'm not like if I was doing something like an article or a call or something, I would want to keep that in there. But for the flight log, I don't. This I do want, rely strictly on the provided text without including external information. Format the summary into paragraphs and bullet points. I'm going to delete that because I have custom formatting I'm going to put in down below. Write in the first person. Yep, I want to keep that. Yes, I want it to keep everything in markdown format. That's generally a good piece of advice to have. I am not going to have it bold anything. I don't want that. I do want it to backlink thing. And I'm going to instruct it how to do that. So I'm going to eliminate that as well. Cool. And then down below here, we have all of the formatting. So here is a good place to, I guess, just kind of write out generally what you want the format to be. So I'm going to say use the following format. Everything should be beneath the parent bullet indented one level. And there's a lot of ways you could do this. I'm just kind of preempting something. So actually before I delete that, this double hashtag here right now will denote that it's an H2 header. I actually don't want any headers or well really anything in this. So I'm just going to delete this whole thing. And I'm going to start here with the parent bullet. And the title of each one is just going to be the date. So I'm going to have it put backlink today. And that will literally put it as today, but then it will change it to that date going forward. So it will always have that. So as long as I do my flight log on that specific day, it should be good. And then everything underneath here, it will hopefully indent one level, but we'll see if it actually succeeds at that. So the first thing that I want to do is the location, which will always say location first. And then I want to backlink, and I'm going to put in parentheses, insert flight launch location here, and hope it backlink that. And then we'll say in, and then I'm also going to backlink, and then I'll put the new name, comma. I'm thinking out loud now. Actually, I'm going to read you. It's going to be tricky. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put in city name, comma, and then state. But why I pause there is because I'm like, what if I'm flying internationally? Which I haven't done yet, but I know I'm going to like to. So we'll just add a guideline here. For the location in the United States, use the city state format. And if it's abroad, use city country format. I know that might not be technically correct, but I'm also going to put parentheses there. And that actually reminded me, one thing I forgot to put in another guideline that I like to do is that word in parentheses like this are filler instructions that you should replace. All right, we'll see how it does with that. Okay, so that's the location and those are backlinked. And then below that, what do I want to do next? I'm going to do length of flight, which will be time, not distance, but maybe later I'll want to add in distance. So I will be, I don't need to backlink that, so I'll just say insert length of flight here. And then below, I will include notes. Include any notes about flight indented underneath this using using bullet. See how it does with that. And then finally, I want to put any to-dos. So that's like, I don't know, maybe I forgot a piece of gear and I'm like, you need to remember a piece of gear or like fix something or something, even practice, that might be a to-do list. So I'll do to-dos, pop through there, or just to-do. And then here I'll put list any action items below using markdown checkboxes like. And I'm also going to say if no action items, do not put anything here. How does that look? Okay. We're starting to look pretty good. I think that's going to be enough for me to try it. So let's save it and see what happens here. All right, I'll pull up my template or custom prompt here and let's see how it does. I will warn you, sometimes it's hard to see exactly how it runs in the preview here, so I'm just going to click replace. Okay, and that was pretty good. I can immediately see some things wrong here. So the first thing wrong is that all of this is supposed to be indented underneath. But if that, let me do that. If it was like that, would that be correct? The today is good. Location, lower launch at Foothills Community Park in Boulder, Colorado. So that's pretty good. I probably would have put that all under one backlink, but actually I think it should be separated. So it actually did better than I intended it. Length of flight, a few minute ETH. Oh, that reminds me. So this will be a flight log if I do multiple flights in one day. So I need to put in there for something for number of flights. The notes look good. The to-do looks good. Okay. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm now going to pull this back up. Just wanted it to stop running there. Okay, paragliding flight log. So then I need to add in, I'm going to put this both in the same one, number and length of flights. And I'm going to do that because usually when I take these voice notes, I don't go through and separate them. I just kind of do it all at once. You can see a lot of this is at the personal preference. And the reason I keep stopping and thinking is because I am literally writing this live and I'm trying to think about how to solve some of these things. Okay, the other thing that I needed to fix is that everything under today should be indented. Excuse me. So I'll say everything beneath here should be indented one level beneath the top bullet line above. I don't know if it's going to work, but okay, I actually need to control Z out of there. And then let's run it again. Dun, dun, dun. And replace it. Boom, perfect, nice. All right, so now we're pretty good. And, excuse me, allergy season. I could add a lot more things here, you know? Like, I could, if I were tracking my height and my literal distance, which I will probably start doing, I'll add that in for the time being. Oh, something I totally forgot. This is really important, actually. I don't have a tack because I think I'm going to want to do these right in my daily note. So what I'm going to do is pull this up. Now, this is really optional because as I'm thinking about this, it's like, well, actually, probably what I will do long term is I'm going to have a dedicated note to this. So if I'm listing all of these under a dedicated note, I don't think I would need the tag. But if I was going to leave these on the daily note, so I'm not actually going to add in a tag for this because, oh man, I'm so on the edge about adding a tag. You know what? No, I'm going to do it. I think I should be adding a tag in here. So let me add a line and it will just say, PG flight. I might go back and change that later, but for the sake of this video, I will save that. Okay, so I'll save that, and then let me go back and run it one more time. Cool, there you go. And so that means then, you know, if I were doing these on daily notes, then I could click on PG flight and see a list of all of my paragliding flights. So that's pretty much it. That is exactly how I do these custom prompts. That's my exact thought process. Sorry if that was a little kind of choppy, but it was an actual live video. I will be literally using this on Saturday when I go to my next flight. So I hope it was useful to someone. It's, you know, I doubt there's very many paragliders watching this, but you can apply it to so many different things. So if you just find yourself regularly recording information, you should probably make an AI prompt around it.